Hello, I'm Saukki, and in this video I would like to talk about cycling shoes and pedals and stuff like that. And if you are new to cycling and you don't know what is a clipless pedals, or if you are new to recumbents and you don't know why you should use clipless pedals, those are the questions I'm going to answer in this video. So, let's go! So, what is a clipless pedal? Well, here I have some examples. So this is basically this kind of pedal with this kind of locking mechanism, and then there is this kind of cleat you have to attach to the bottom of your cycling shoe. And then basically how this works is that you put the cleat to the locking mechanism like this, and now your shoe is attached to the pedal, and you can release your shoe from the pedal just twisting it to the side like this. Like that. Well, it's much easier to release the shoe if the pedal is attached to the bike. So here I will demonstrate it with actual bike. So just push the cleat into the pedal like this. And then if you want to release, just twist your ankle to the side like this. Pretty easy. But then one thing you may ask, why these pedals that you have to clip in with your shoe is called clipless pedals? Well, back in the days, the racing cyclists used this kind of pedals with this toe clip. That was actually pretty inconvenient, but that was the best thing at the time. And then later, when the manufacturers came up with this quick-release clip-in pedal, they needed some way to differentiate this type of pedals from these old toe clip pedals. So that's why they called these clipless pedals, because these don't have the toe clip. So that's the only reason they are called clipless pedals. It was just marketing. But okay then, why you should use clipless pedals? Well, I think that in general, cyclists use clipless pedals to increase the performance. It's much more easier to output more power when your shoe is attached to the pedal and your shoe is not slipping on the pedal. So it should be much easier. But then, especially as a recumbent riders, you really should use clipless pedals. And why is that? Well, actually, I made a video about this earlier. I leave the link in the here in the corner and in the video description, so you can go check that video. But basically there's two important things why recumbent riders should use clipless pedals. First, you don't need to waste any extra energy to keep your foot to the pedals, because, well, they are attached to the pedals and not going anywhere. And the second thing is that clipless pedals for recumbents, it's almost like a safety feature, like a seatbelt in the car, especially with trikes and velomobiles. Because if your feet drops from the pedal, then it can go under the trike frame or something like that. Or you can hit the edge of the velomobile foothole or something. And that's not good. So it's much more safer if your foot is attached to the pedals and not going anywhere. So it's like a safety feature. But okay then, what kind of different kind of pedals and cleats there are? Well, almost every manufacturer have their own kind of system. Actually, there's many different kind of systems, but you can roughly divide those systems into two main categories, mountain bike pedals and road bike pedals. And I think that most of recumbent riders use mountain bike type of pedals because the shoes and cleats are more convenient. And here on the table I only have these mountain bike type of pedals because, well, I mostly use these kind of pedals. But actually the Quest has this road bike type of pedals, and that's only because I wanted to have this power meter. And this power meter that I have, I think this is one of the cheapest one, and that's why I wanted to buy this one. And it comes with this kind of road bike type of pedals. So that's why I use this road bike type of pedals and cleats. And the Azub here at the back has this double-sided pedals, so that there's a mountain bike clipless pedal on the other side and then a flat pedal on the other side. But actually I never use the flat side because it's much more comfortable to ride with the clipless pedals. Okay, so the difference between the cleats is pretty huge, as you can see here. This one is a mountain bike type of cleat. It's much smaller. And this is the road bike type of cleat. And this is much more larger, as you can see. I think people think that this kind of larger cleats increases the performance. Maybe it feels much more comfortable to pedal with this kind of larger cleat compared to this small cleat, because there's much more larger surface area with the cleat. But I don't know, I don't feel that kind of difference with the different shoes and cleats and pedals. Okay then, what kind of different kind of shoes there are? Well, first of all, these are, as you already saw, these are mountain bike shoes and these are road bike shoes. And the cleats are of course different. And there's of course different kind of mounting holes for the cleats, because as you can see, this one has only two holes and this one has three holes and different hole pattern. But then what's also different is that this bottom of the shoe, there's proper thread pattern here at the with this mountain bike shoe. If you are mountain biking, then you probably have to sometimes walk and you need some kind of traction to your shoes so you don't fall. But the road bike shoe, the bottom is this kind of hard plastic and this is very slippery actually. And because the cleat is like this on the bottom of the shoe, it's very inconvenient to walk with this kind of shoes. So you just don't want to walk with this kind of road bike shoes and this huge cleat. It's very inconvenient and it makes a lot of noise. So I think that's one of the reasons that most of the recumbent riders are using this kind of mountain bike shoes and cleats and pedals, because this is much more convenient. If you are, for example, going for grocery shopping with your velomobile, then it's much more comfortable to walk in the shop with this kind of shoe. This is much better for walking. Then of course the sole stiffness is different. I think this is much more softer. You can little bit bend this like this. But with these road shoes, I think these are much more harder and stiffer. I think that increases the performance, so you can output more power with this kind of stiff shoes. Then I also have here a winter shoe. This is basically a mountain bike type of shoe with the mountain bike cleats and mounting holes for this kind of cleat. And of course, winter shoe needs to have a good thread pattern so you don't slip in the snow. Well, you probably have to walk on snow. Actually about these shoes, these are not very warm shoes, even though this looks like this is a winter shoe. This is not warm enough in the Finnish winter. And actually this kind of road bike shoe and road bike cleat, this is very inconvenient in winter, because this is very slippery shoe, so you don't want to use this kind of shoes in winter. And actually I think that some velomobile riders who use this kind of road bike shoes, they carry extra pair of shoes inside the velomobile, because well, there is space for shoes. So they cycle with this kind of shoes, and then when they have to, for example, go to grocery shopping or go to coffee break or something, they switch to other shoes which are easier to walk with. Okay then, how to find the right cycling shoe for you? Well, I think the best way is just trial and error, because if you are just buying your first cycling shoes, then you probably have no idea what kind of shoes to get. The best idea is to go to local bike shop and try some shoes. And actually I have a story here. I bought this shoes a few years ago. These actually have mounting holes for both type of cleats. There's this three hole pattern for the road bike cleat, and then this two hole system for the mountain bike type of cleats. But anyway, this is more like a road bike type of shoe, because the sole is this kind of hard plastic and very slippery. But anyway, I went to the local bike shop and tried some different shoes, and these shoes, these felt very good on the shop, and I bought this one. And then I started to ride with these, and after some time I started to feel that my other foot started to get some pain. And I didn't know where that was coming from, and then later I realized that it was these shoes. So these felt good at the bike shop, but then at actually using these caused some pain to my feet. So I had to just buy new shoes. So it's not always enough just to go to the bike shop and test different shoes. The shoe may still not be the right one for you. Then one thing about these Shimano shoes, or at least Shimano shoes. These are usually pretty small in size, so I think this one is maybe two sizes larger than my normal walking shoes. So that's something you should keep in mind when you buy shoes. You probably have to go for a little bit larger size than normal, because these are pretty tiny. Then now that you have bought a new shoes and new pedals, then how to find the right position for the cleat, because as you could see here, you can move the mounting holes like this. So how to find the right position for the cleat? Well, that's also trial and error. In my opinion, it's best to start to put the cleat as far back as it goes, like here, and then start from there and maybe try different settings. But I think that with recumbent bikes, this far back setting, it's maybe the best one. But that's only my opinion, so you have to test it yourself. But okay, I think that's everything I have to say about these shoes and pedals. What's your opinion? What kind of shoes and pedals you are using and why? Leave your comments below the video at the comment section and let's have a conversation. But okay, I think that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Please remember to subscribe to my channel. Just click the subscription button below the video. And then also click that bell icon so you can get notification every time I post a new video. And then visit my webshop and buy something like, well, this kind of awesome t-shirts or something else, like bag or mug or something. But anyway, thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.